I think that we should look at healthcare just like we look at education. You're going to get a basic healthcare benefit if you're a citizen of the United States, just like you're going to get an education picture. I was working really hard on trying to increase coverage at the state level and try to bring some more justice to our healthcare system through state reform. I ran for Congress in part because I ended up hitting a brick wall in trying to solve our state's healthcare crisis through state change. Ultimately, healthcare is mostly federal law.
Voters deserve to know the difference between Linda McMahon on the issue of women's health care because the difference is gigantic. Now, my record on this issue is clear. In 1998, I built a coalition of women's groups to take on and defeat one of the leading anti-choice, anti-women Republican legislators in Hartford. And a year later, I was instrumental in helping Connecticut pass a landmark law that guarantees insurance coverage for birth control. In Congress, I helped lead the fight to pass health care reform, which says once and for all that a woman is not going to be charged more for health care insurance simply because she's a woman. And in that bill, I authored a provision which sets up offices of women's health care at all of the major federal health care agencies to make sure that women's voices are represented when decisions are being made about their health care at the federal government. And as a senator, I will never, ever support a leader of my party or a chairman of the Judiciary Committee that will support anti-choice, anti-woman candidates for the Supreme Court.
There's really not a month that goes by without a different piece of legislation on the floor that's seeking to restrict a woman's right to choose, trying to deny funding to a lot of the organizations that provide reproductive health care services like Planned Parenthood to women across this country. You know, the Republicans have made it pretty clear that not only do they oppose abortion being available to a woman that chooses that option, but they also don't even want basic family planning services like contraception available to women who want to use contraception, despite the fact that 99% of women do. So what we're fighting here in Washington is, you know, not just a fight over whether or not women are going to have the ability to choose what to do with their own bodies, but whether or not women are still going to have access to birth control. We thought that issue was settled 50 years ago. But right now, we're back to fighting what we thought was a settled question over family planning services.
Linda McMahon has a very different vision for women's health care. She might be telling people over the course of this campaign that she's pro-choice, but her election would virtually assure that the United States Senate would be run by right-wing leadership that will work every day to overturn Roe versus Wade and criminalize a woman's right to choose. She wants to repeal the law that would end the practice of women being charged more simply because of their gender. And she openly advertises that she'll side with the right wing in allowing any employer in this country to arbitrarily deny women access for insurance coverage for prescription birth control.
I fought my entire life to try to make sure that people who are gay or lesbian are treated exactly the same as everyone else. We're getting closer to that day. We certainly made the right steps in Connecticut. But in Washington, we are fighting, you know, a homophobic agenda. And there's nothing, there's nothing more to say about it. We're fighting people who don't like gays and lesbians and don't want the law to protect them. And it's really sad that we're continuing this battle, but it's real in Washington, even if it's increasingly settled in states like Connecticut.